and
expected
snow.
That half the country will tune into the Age of Reason, the biggest music event of our bicentenary. Australian of the Year John Farnham will take the stage to World Expo in a concert which will be telecast live throughout the Seven Network. In a moment, we'll talk to John. But first, Pat McGuinness traces the life of this very special Australian.
Instill national pride in our children. But please, let's make our national pride encompass humanity. Thank you very much.
Australian of the Year and Born Again success story. John Farnham has taken good and bad in 21 years of rock and roll. 1988 is his year, and the performances at Expo, the highlight of a long career.
How you going? Jesus, what a night! I saw most of you people on the news today.
The early days brought a string of bubblegum hits, but the king of pop always had a community voice. Farnham flew into Brisbane in 1971, just days after Joe Cocker had been caught with marijuana.
You know, it's going to deter anybody coming into the country, which makes it very hard. And he has, I think, contributed very, very largely to ruining big shows here. If you want me, come and get me. You don't have a chance.
A string of awards didn't assure permanent success. In 1982, Farnham joined the Little River Band. For some reason, it just didn't work.
But, I was in financial difficulty there a little while back, and the fact that I didn't make a great deal of money out of the Little River Band sort of helped to compound that problem. So, I decided that if I was going to pressurise myself one more time, I was going to do it for 100% of the reasons. I'll stand or fall on what I do.
It's John Farnham with the other guys!
John Farnham became an international star. His Whispering Jack album, the most successful in this country's recording history. Being named Australian of the Year was almost too much.
It's been an amazing year. I didn't think, after the baby arriving and everything being so great this year, that anything could get better. But it's been amazing.
In our bicentennial year, John Farnham is Australia's best-loved performer. His new album, Age of Reason, is set to break the records of its brother Jack.
John Farnham, thanks for joining us.
It's a pleasure, Andrew. Thank you.
You had people waiting, queuing up for your concert yesterday at 10 o'clock in the morning, 4 hours before the concert started. It was totally packed out. That's a lot to live up to, isn't it?
It is. It puts a lot of pressure on me, but I'm very grateful for the fact that people really want to get there and see the thing. And I did see it on the news, and I did thank them when I finally got there. But, it's pretty daunting to know that the place was full up at 4:30 or something.
Do you know what it is that makes people do that?
No idea. No idea.
You must have some idea.
I mean, the record's been a hit, and you know, people were coming to the concerts, and I guess that thing sort of rolls like a snowball. But I don't know. If I'd have known what it was.
But why is it snowballing? Why? I mean, have you ever asked yourself, here I am, John Farnham. My God, look what's happening.
Oh, absolutely. Every morning, mate, I wake up and I don't believe what's going on. I woke up this morning, I was on the front page of the newspaper with positive things said about the concert last night. That is absolute joy. I can't tell you What a joy that is. I love it. I love it. And what I say as well is that, I mean, the thing that success has given me, I've been very lucky. I've been successful for quite some time.
And a few times.
And a few times. That's true. I mean, this is my second bite of the cherry. And
the most important one?
The most important one. And I've got to say, I'm enjoying it more now than I ever did.
Because you understand it
well,
better?
Well, yeah, I understand a lot more about it. I have a lot more control over the circumstances under which I work. And what the success has given me is the opportunity to do it under the best circumstances I can, with the best people I can.
See, what I see with something like this mm-hmm. is that it's not a taking sort of thing, it's a giving. You're giving out.
Well, I think it
has to. And that's what people are reacting to. Do you see it that way?
Possibly. I don't know. It's not a conscious effort. I don't sort of really go out and set myself up an image or anything like that. It's not really the way I work. That's what you see is what you get, and that's basically it. Obviously, these things are marketed in the best possible way.
Yeah, sure.
And they really try and do that, but I can only give what I've got to give and give it in the best way I can.
All right, what are you giving?
As much of myself as I can.
All right.
I love to do it, and I love to get back what comes back.
All right, but what is yourself? See, I mean, I look at Age of Reason, for instance, and just looking at that clip, for instance, mm-hmm. and all the kids there.
Yeah.
I mean, you've obviously changed since having kids.
Sure. Oh, yeah. Well, I think that's been the biggest change in me. It has made me, because when I was running around the country as a pop singer, I really only had time to think about myself. And think about what I was doing. And I saw someone quoted on the television the other day that's saying we only really borrow our time on the planet from our children, because they're the ones who end up with it. And that just keeps going like that. And I look at my kids and I think, well, gee, why with all this common sense that we say we should have, are we still killing each other? It's bloody stupid. It really is. It's dumb.
Yes, we're supposedly intelligent human beings, and look what we're doing to ourselves.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so what sort of world
look what we're doing to each other, too. You know?
Yes, indeed. Which gets us onto the Australian of the Year to a degree.
Mm-hmm.
What are we doing to ourselves?
Well, we're mucking up what we've got. I mean, this is the only place in the universe. I mean, this is a bit brown rice and hairy legs. So I don't mean it that
sure.
way. But this is it. This is it. You know, I mean, there's a hole in the ozone layer. That's crazy. We know what things create that. And we must stop all that stuff.
All right, so what sort of world are you, through things like this and what you're saying in songs like this? Because I listen to the words and I'm sure a lot of people...
It's the first thing I look at.
So what is it, the message that you're trying to get through? I mean, you talked about positivity before.
Yeah. Positivity, yeah, sure. And look at what we're leaving behind us for your children and my children and everyone else's children. We're leaving them a dirty, great big mess, you know? I think we should clean our act up a little bit, actually a lot. But I can't get into the deep dark politics of it or make any prophecies or anything like that. Ultimately, all I am is a singer, and I can make the comments that I make with the lyrics that I can use in songs, and hopefully capture someone's imagination and make them think about it.
Without going too far overboard.
Without going too far overboard. Right. I'm not a politician's bum. I can't do any of that stuff. I can only make my comment in my way, and people have been sort of asking me all sorts of political questions along with my Australian of the Year thing, and I'm not a politician. I don't want to go into all that. I'm as a singer.
See, quite a lot of Australians have said, John Farnham, he's just a singer, mm-hmm. he's just an entertainer, a good one, sure. But why is he Australian of the Year?
Well, that's exactly what I say. I don't know. I have no idea.
Yeah, but you have been interested in a couple of things that are pretty close.
Yeah, but I have no idea why I was chosen as the Australian of the Year. I saw a list of people that were nominated for the Australian of the Year, and I don't think I'd have voted for me. No, I really mean that, though. And that's not...
John Farnham, I think I would have voted for you.
Yeah, well, I thank you for that. But I mean, all I can do is do what I do and be positive about it and hopefully instill some of that positivity and what I hope I have as common sense in kids.
Well, we wish you all the best for tonight's concert. I know that most of Australia will be watching it.
Thanks, Andrew. Thank you very much.
At least they all won't be able to fit into Expo.
That's true.
John Farnham, thank you.
Thanks, mate.